Hello students, welcome to online lectures of Kids Planet High School. This lecture is for class 3, subject CBS, lesson R environment. Let us now begin. Environment. So you know what is environment? Well, just look at the picture carefully. We are about to begin. Children, I hope you all have seen the last picture carefully. The last picture was a short example of our environment. We see many things around us, like stone, rock, soil, stream, river, lake. Children, there is also air, there are hills and mountains. Children, we see many different things in our environment. There are jungles where wild animals live. There are fields where crops are grown. There are houses where we live. There are roads where vehicles run. There are barren lands. Children, barren lands are the lands where trees or plants cannot be grown. Children, there are different types of animals around us. In this picture, you can see elephant, lion, giraffe, zebra, deer, and many other animals. These animals live in jungle. They are called wild animals. Now, let us have a look at our next picture. Children, in this picture, you can see cow, sheep, horse, pig, dog, etc. These animals can be kept at our house. We also use these animals to earn money. These animals are called domestic animals. Children, there are different types of plants around us. Let us study about them. Trees. Trees are tall plants with long branches, leaves, and fruits. Bushes. Bushes are small plants with many small branches. Bushes are generally round in shape. Climbers. Climbers are the plants which need support to grow, like grapes. Creepers. Creepers are the plants that grow on ground. They do not grow tall, like pumpkin. Children, as you can see in the picture, we all are also a part of environment. Children, various things in our environment can be divided into living things and non-living things. Children, as you can see in the picture, all these are living things. Living things grow and move. They need food and water to live. They give birth to young ones. Now, let us look at our next picture. These are non-living things. Non-living things do not eat or drink. They do not breathe. They do not grow or move. They do not give birth to young ones. Let us now understand the difference between living thing and non-living thing with the help of an example. Let us take an example of sparrow and stone. Let us first study about sparrow. Sparrow can move here and there on their own. Sparrow eats insects and grains. That is why they grow. Children, just as we eat food and grow, sparrow eats insects and grains. That is why they grow. Sparrow builds nest. Sparrow builds its own house, as you can see in the picture. Sparrow lays eggs in nest. Little sparrows hatch out from these eggs. Sparrow takes a lot of care of their young ones, just as a mother takes care of us. Now we will learn about stone. Stone doesn't eat, doesn't breathe. Stone doesn't move on its own. Stone doesn't grow. And because of all these reasons, sparrow is a living thing and stone is a non-living thing. We can further classify living things into plants and animals. Let us first study about plants. Seedlings grow from seeds. Seedlings then grow into plants. This tells us that plants are living things because they can grow. Plants do not move from place to place like animals do because roots hold them down. For animals, they are similar to the nature of sparrows that we have learned earlier. What do we get from environment? Living things need air, water, and food to live. They get all of these from environment. For example, birds need cotton, twigs, and threads to build their nest. They get these things from environment. They collect all these from environment. Human beings also use so many things from environment. We get cotton from plants, wool from sheep, and silk from silkworms, which are also a part of environment. We can weave clothes from them. We can make clothes from all these materials. Just like this, we get many other things from environment, which gives us a better life. We make mats, baskets, and papers from materials we get from environment. We get clay, stone, and wood from environment, which are used to make house. Seeds are carried by the wind and get mixed with the soil. This helps the plants and trees to grow in new places. All living and non-living things of environment help in each other's growth. Let us see how. Vultures and foxes eat the dead animals to satisfy their hunger. This helps to clean the environment. Children, birds like vultures and animals like foxes eat the dead animals. This helps them to fill their stomach and also helps to keep the environment clean. Also, dead animals rot and get mixed in the soil. Dry leaves do fall and get mixed in the soil. This makes the soil fertile. Fertile soil helps the plants to grow well. Children, when dead animals rot, जब वो सड़ने लगते हैं, they get mixed in the soil. Dry leaves also fall and get mixed in the soil. Soil is mitti, as you can see in the picture. When all these things get mixed into the soil, this makes the soil fertile. Fertile soil has all the good nutrients which helps the plants to grow well. Children, do you know sheep eats small leaves from small plants? And as you know, they have wool all over their body. Seeds of plants get stuck on sheep's body. When the sheep moves to different places, the seeds are dropped at various places, which also helps in planting seeds in new places and helps the small plants to grow in different places. In this way, the sheep, which is an animal, and the shrub, which is a plant, help each other in their growth. This was your lesson, Our Environment.